Hey everyone, Sunil here with Datalocker to talk about some of the key features of our new PortBlocker application. Now, PortBlocker is our simply secure approach to data loss prevention for removable storage that puts control in the hands of you as the administrator as to which USB mass storage devices are allowed to be mounted on your users' workstations. Now, because each environment is different, we're not actually going to walk through the application deployment itself, but rest assured that we've worked hard to make it as simple as possible to install and register each workstation in a way that best fits your workflow. Everything from individual installations to mass deployment with silent installation, we've got you covered. Check out the links at the end of this video for more in-depth details on deployment options for your environment. Now, we are, however, going to take a quick look at how simple it is to configure the policy for your workstations from the SafeConsole server all the way down to a granular level. Check it out. Once you've logged into your SafeConsole account, navigate to the Policies section by selecting Manage Policies from the left-hand side. Keep in mind that PortBlocker will automatically block all USB mass storage devices unless specifically whitelisted in the policy, and that all PortBlocker installations will use the default policy for the whitelist unless a custom policy is assigned. Let's take a look at the default policy by selecting Modify Default Policy at the top of the page and selecting the PortBlocker tab in the pop-up. From here, you can simply expand the list of SafeConsole ready devices, which is conveniently pre-populated for you, and select which devices you would like to whitelist or set as read-only for your workstations, as listed by vendor, model, or even down to the serial number. And then just click Save. Once the whitelist is saved, the workstations will then automatically check for the policy updates and adjust their whitelist to match what you set. Additionally, PortBlocker will report each time a device is successfully blocked, mounted, or mounted as read-only for each workstation, and those events are available for your review under the User Audit Logs section within the console. Also, for any devices that are not currently listed in the console and were blocked by PortBlocker, you can easily add them to the whitelist right from the dashboard simply by clicking the wrench next to the action under the Recent Events widget and then clicking Add. One last thing I want to point out is the ability to schedule access for a specific workstation. Under the Manage PortBlocker section, you can set a workstation to allow all devices, or block all devices, and then schedule a time when you'd like that change to take place. Well, thanks for watching this high-level overview, everyone. If you're interested in more information or would like to try out PortBlocker in your environment, be sure to hit up our website at datalocker.com/PortBlocker.